Good evening and welcome to tonight's recital of Auschwitz, Jewish composers persecuted by the Nazis in commemoration of the 79th anniversary of Kristallnacht. My name is Carsten Schaffko from the Schusterman Center for Judaic and Israel Studies here at the University of Oklahoma, and I will briefly introduce the program to you and provide some historical context. As well as for the past three concerts focusing on Jewish music, it was again Professor Alon Richstone from OU's Music School who put this program together. By organizing this concert, it was Professor Richstone's foremost goal to remember these outstanding artists and leading composers of their time: Leo Smith, Paul Hermer, Dick Kattenberg, Martin Spaniard, and James Simon, who all perished during the Holocaust. They and their music are almost forgotten today. The recital tonight will change this. I would like to thank the Jewish Federation of Oklahoma City, OU School of Music, and the Schusterman Center for Judaic and Israel Studies for making this program possible. Like almost all Jewish communities in Europe, Jews settled in the Low Countries during the Middle Ages. Beginning in the 16th century, Sephardic Jews settled in the southern parts of the Netherlands, what would later become the Kingdom of the Belgians. The Emancipation Decree of 1792 made Jews equal before the law earlier than in many other European countries. During the course of the 19th century, we can see an increase in upward mobility among Dutch Jews. Still, a majority of the Jews in the Netherlands remained poor. The years from 1870 until 1940 witnessed a rapid growth in the Jewish community. Dutch Jews identified with the Netherlands, they saw themselves as Dutch and were part of the overall society. To a degree, we do not see in other parts of Europe during that time. Dutch Jews also contributed to the sciences, fine arts and music in the Netherlands. Yet they also helped to establish a distinct Dutch Jewish subculture. In 1930, 44% of all Dutch Jews lived in Amsterdam, the cultural capital of the Netherlands. When Hitler came to power in Germany in 1933, some 34,000 Jewish refugees from Germany arrived. German Jews were assisted by Dutch Jewish organizations to find a home in the Netherlands, most of them in Amsterdam. All in all, 16,000 German Jews will remain in the Netherlands during the 1930s. Numbers cannot explain the horrific years awaiting Dutch Jews, as well as all Jews in German-occupied Europe. In 1940, the Netherlands were put under German occupation, which will last until May 5, 1945. Music was forbidden if the composer had a Jewish background during those years. Likewise, performers and composers with a Jewish background were deported. Their property was looted and their musical heritage was eliminated. As in the fate of the artists we are commemorating tonight, the first deportation sent men, women and children from Amsterdam or any other place in the Netherlands to the Westerbork concentration camp. From here, they were deported to Auschwitz or Sobibor or killed in Lithuania, as in the case of Paul Hermann. Although the Dutch people showed more open resistance against these measures, in the end, this does not stop the deportations. By the end of the war, 74%, 102,600 out of 140,000 of all Jews living in the Netherlands that were considered to be Jewish following the Nuremberg Laws, perished during the Holocaust, including the artist we are in particular commemorating tonight. We are commemorating and do not forget them. these outstanding artists and their music. I hope you will all enjoy this very, very special musical program tonight. Please give a warm welcome to Julie Davis, soprano, Valerie Watts, flute, Joel Burkham, tenor, Leslie Flanagan, baritone, Jonathan Rook, cello, and Lord Richstone, piano. Thank you.
Oh!